10 favorite films. There are hundreds of films, of course, that we can talk about all day long. But still, today I would like to show my favorite 10 films. Most of them are thrillers that keep you at the edge of your seat till the very end. So, let's get started. The first is The Curious Case of Benjamin Button, that was released in 2008, and it was starring Brad Pitt and Kate Blanchett. This gripping, vividly dramatic story revolves around a man who suffers from a unique disease. He starts aging backwards with bizarre consequences. It is worth mentioning that from the opening scene till the final scene, the film is not only vividly dramatic and realistic, but also it is technically brilliant. The director managed to show show Brad Pitt's age changing and war scenes so true to reality that we can easily forget that we are sitting in the cinema hall and we're on the screen with the actors. So, unfortunately, I think that it is somehow not dull, but slow-moving and drag-out in shots. But still, it is, well, needless to say that this film won 3 Oscars. So, I advise all of you to watch it, at least once. Another film that is worth mentioning is Illusionist. It is a 2006 picture about love, magic and simple life. Though the film seems murky in shots, still it leaves a positive and lasting impression on you. This picture with Edward Norton and Jessica Biel depicts the life and love of a magician who uses all his abilities to secure the love of a woman far above his social standing. The picture is a good example of a successful screen version of a novel. So, in order to feel all the magic, and in order to admire Edward Norton acting on the screen, don't miss it. Another fairy tale about magicians, about magic, about love, true love, and moreover about friendship is The Prestige. This star-studded film depicts the story about obsession, jealousy, and the tense relationship between two turn-of-the-century magicians. Rupert and Alfred are London-based showmen of the highest order, both blessed with spectacular powers and deception, and at the same time are both blessed with envy of one another's skills. The battle, and especially the end, that is completely unbelievable. That is, it is even impossible, I believe, to predict the end. Everything makes you to rewatch this film at least once in order to understand the plot, in order to understand this secret, because it just baffles you. From my point of view, the film is full of abstract and complex ideas. What a twist! Let's pass over to some creepy and frightening picture, which aim is to make your heart beat as fast as it can. In general, this thriller, Silent Hill, it is not only a thriller actually, but it is also a horror and a drama film, which is the perfect adaptation of the game ever seen. The crew's work was tough and extremely hard and enormous, but they did succeed in making the film. In order the picture not to become a flop, the great efforts were taken not only by actors, well, the leading actors that were playing some creepy roles of monsters, but also by costumes and scenery designers. They even had to transform a part of a city in order to make you feel the real atmosphere of the film. This film follows a loving mother who takes her adopted daughter to Silent Hill, the only clue of her sleepwalking condition. After being knocked unconscious in a car crash, she awakens to find her daughter in that foggy, creepy town with falling ash instead of snow. Or maybe it was ashes, who knows. She proceeds to search the town for her daughter and discovers the real connection between her daughter and this murky, strange, desolate place. I won't tell you the secret in the end, because it is really absorbing and worth seeing. So, let's pass over to something more comfortable and more usual maybe. And it is the film Keith. Jess McCarthy takes the title role in director and screenwriter Todd Kelsey's 2008 drama about a senior student named Natalie, who is played by Elizabeth Harris, who believes that her life is figured out until she meets a strange and unpredictable youth named Keith, who begins to alter her life the way she has never imagined is possible. Keith is based on Ron Charlson's short story of the same name, and the adaptation turned out to be life-affirming and so dramatic that even that some critics claim that it is better than the book itself. So, if you want to cry a little bit, if you want to think about life's positive sides, just do watch it. Those who have ever read Stephen King's novels, or at least have heard about this horror master, won't miss the next thrilling picture, 1408. So, the plot of this picture revolves around a writer who describes and debunks infamous places that are full of ghosts or some other stuff, mystery stuff. He is confronted by a force that he can't explain upon checking room 1408 of the notoriously haunted Dolphin Hotel. Thanks to such seasoned actors as John Cusack and Samuel L. Jackson, and of course thanks to special effects designers, this film is claimed to be the decade's most haunting motion picture about ghost stories. 1408 is a welcome and refreshing change of a place from the flattery of gore-splattered horror films, where blood and gore are everywhere. So it is not foul, unclean, or repulsive, or just disgusting. It is gripping, it is an amazing picture that presents ghosts and other powers of outer world in such a brilliant way. If you want to tremble a bit, just go and see this film. You know, Kat, there is another film that is worth mentioning. Do you know what it is? Of course not. It is Mr. Nobody, the film with so famous and lovely Jared Leto. The film depicts a story about a boy, a man, an old man, who suffers from a curious disease. He can predict everything in life, in his life in particular. 117-year-old Nila Nobody is ill and facing last days of his life. And he looks back on his past and a particular crucial moment. At the age of 9, Nemo's parents divorced, and as his mother and father stood on a train platform, he had to choose who to stay with. So that was a turning point of his life, and either choice would bring a wide variety of possibilities regarding to the sort of life he would lead, and Nemo imagines nearly all of them. That's the very point of his unhappiness, because he knows everything beforehand. Another vividly dramatic and romantic and sentimental drama to be watched. Fight Club is a shocking, absorbing, possibly dangerous drama, thriller, and even detective picture that was released in 1999. In addition, it belongs to a small minority of films that reveals and discovers the ills, shortcomings, and harsh realities of our life. The film story revolves around an insomniac office worker, played by Edward Norton, who hates his job and his life of empty of serious content. So in order to get over his disease, the insomnia, he begins visiting the group of support in order to witness more severe sufferings. Soon after, he gets addicted to it. His life becomes completely weird after him meeting two people, Marla Singer, another group support tourist, and Tyler Durden, whom he meets on the plane. Eventually, Tyler Durden and the nameless narrator arrange a fight club where men can pair off their frustrations that they overcome on a daily basis. But the very secret that comes at the very end is so baffling, is So don't hesitate to watch it up to the very end, because it is not the answer to all the questions, but it is the starting point to think, to realize. The next film in my list is partly drama, partly fantasy, with obscure and complex ideas. It is Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. The film tells us about a man who is informed that his ex-girlfriend has had the memories of their relationship erased from her brain during some experimental procedure performed by some doctor. In order not to be undone, he decides to have the same procedure done to himself. But when it comes to the point, he struggles to save the memories of her from being deleted. So only through the process of loss they discover what they had to begin with. It must be mentioned that the roles played by magnificent Jim Carrey and Kate Winslet require a lot of subtlety and a lot of psychological angst. So this outstanding movie makes us think about the point of love, life, and memories themselves. So the last film in my list is about service, but it is not funny as it may seem from the first view. The name of the film is The Butterfly Circus, a color sound short-length film created by Joshua and Rebecca Wiggins about dreams and how they can come true. Although the duration of the film is only 20 minutes, it implies a lot of ideas, a lot of senses, and I, for example, was so touched by the plot, by the actors, by them playing on the screen, that I was crying at the end of the film. At the height of Great Depression, the showman of renowned circus leads his troupe through the devastated American landscape, lifting the spirits of audiences along the way. During their travels, they discover a man without limbs on a carnival sideshow. However, after an intriguing encounter with the director, with the showman, this man becomes driven to hope against everything he had ever believed. And after watching this film, I'm sure that no one can fail to become aware of the importance of life, of the importance of it, however and whatever may happen to you. So, that's it. My 10 favorite films. You may disagree with me on some points, on some movies, but still, I strongly believe that each of them deserves at least one watching by you. After all, if at least one viewer is mesmerized by a film, by the cinematography in general, it will exist. And this is it, the magic of the eighth wonder. See you later, alligator! That is twice now anymore. It's not the same. Now the trails lead to the outer regions. Echoes from the other world turn horizons into endless ever present. Я помню, мама бабушка просто всегда. Помнила эту дурачью песню. Много, а знал, что там так.
Как? Сука. Мама еще царапается.
Но меня он сейчас убьет. Не надо этого говорить. Sympathize. What are you doing? Okay, thank you very much, my dear.
Привет маме, папе, друзьям.